Hi, sports fans. You're now tuning in to Chicks in the Sports, the hottest sports show in the A. This is your girl, the self-proclaimed sports nista, your Gary Thomas, with...
I am Lita Lee, a.k.a. at Lita Wins.
Hi, this is Erica Blunt, the sports diva.
Hey, hey, it's your girl, Alicia Bostic.
Hey, world, it's your sports guru. It's Bonnie, baby.
That game will never be the same. Game on!
Game on, game on. This is your girl, the self-proclaimed sports nista, Yukiri Thomas. We have an exciting, exciting day today. I'm here with my girl, Erica and Alicia, holding me down. How y'all doing?
Hey, hey. How's it going?
Yes. So, oh my goodness, we have such an amazing guest that's coming up.
Yes.
You know, so excited about her. But we have to get in. Before we get any further, let's just kill it, jump out of the way. Super Bowl, what happened?
Congratulations to the Philadelphia Eagles.
And everybody else in the United States besides Patriots.
Oh, my gosh, right?
Oh, yeah, the Patriots. Good effort. Good effort.
You know, okay, so let's do it quickly. Good, bad, and ugly. Each of you tell me.
Oh, good, bad, and ugly. Well, good, Eagles won.
Yes, of course, right?
Bad, the Patriots didn't win.
Aww.
Ugly. The Patriots didn't get their sixth Super Bowl. They didn't get their sixth ring. So that's
so
the
sorry.
Ugly.
Okay.
There's always next year.
It's always next year. Always.
I'm now, feeling good. Nick Foles.
Okay.
What a human. What a football player. Could not be more excited for him and his team.
Okay.
And I loved his little post-game speech. Yeah. I loved everything about that. Like, I was feeling inspirational.
Yeah.
And then, bad. I don't know. I guess I feel bad for the city of Philly because I'm sure that their city is absolutely destroyed.
I know, right?
I think I saw people climbing up poles, literally replacing Brady Street with Full Street.
What?
I saw that picture.
What?
I was
also like kind of nervous for the aftermath of what their city looks like after the parade yesterday.
I heard they were burning things too around the
flipping cars.
Yeah.
Yes.
True Philadelphia fashion.
They're going wild in Philly.
Yes. And then ugly. I don't know.
What was that?
There was not much ugly play. Nobody said anything ugly to each other that I know of.
Not much conflict.
Yeah, it was pretty
good.
It was pretty easy.
It could have gotten ugly. You know, some football players have super anger issues, and, you know, when it's not going your way, it gets the best of you. But no conflict there, so.
Okay.
Good sportsmanship.
Ship all the way around.
Yeah.
I mean, but, you know, I guess my good, bad, and ugly is, of course, I'm riding the bandwagon with the Eagles. This is the first time they won.
Same.
You know, underdogs. Who doesn't like the underdogs?
Yeah.
I guess my bad is the Patriots' shocking decision to bench the cornerback, Malcolm Butler, you know. Of course, there was a lot of stuff going on after the fact about why he was benched. Some were saying because he missed curfew. He said, no, that wasn't the case. But again, he was benched. The ugly was watching Tom Brady and his tomfoolery fumbling the ball on New England's last chance to drive to the win the game. That's my good, bad, and ugly. Tomfoolery. You like that? You like that, Sky? Creative play.
That's good.
That was nice, I have to say.
I'm just saying. Okay, so, like, the halftime show. That was a big controversy.
Yeah.
Ooh, maybe that was my ugly.
Was it really? Oh, my gosh. What?
I did not like it. No.
What do you mean?
I felt left wanting. I finished it, and I said, that was it. Really, I felt like we had talked about all week. Who's he going to bring out?
JT's going to bring out NC. Maybe.
Didn't bring out anyone besides visual effects of Prince.
Which was also really controversial. Earlier in the week before the Super Bowl, Sheila E. tweeted and was like, you know, Prince told me when he was alive to never have a hologram of me. You know, and I know from being just a Prince fan, he was very, very private. So I can understand why. But at the same time, you know, if it's in his honor, they're in Minnesota. I mean, I get
it.
I totally get it. It makes sense.
But they painted the city purple, too, in this honor.
They did.
But, again, if you think about Prince, like you said, Prince, he seemed like one of those guys that would have been like, once it's all said and done, leave me alone.
Yes,
you know, like, absolutely. No tributes. Just let me be, you know.
I agree.
Let me rest in peace. But I definitely We'll say the JT's performance to me, it was just reminiscent of the old days.
Yeah, I agree.
I love the songs. I'm sorry, I'm just a big JT. He could never do wrong.
Yeah, I would be the selfie kid.
I probably would have been. Oh my God!
Except you would have known the words.
I know, right? I'm a totally fangirl.
Oh my God! So I did enjoy the performance. Again, I understand the respect factor because it was very controversial from the beginning. Should mm-hmm. he bring out the hologram? Should he not bring out? That's disrespectful. But yet, if you think about it, it's...
But he did say that he talked to Questlove, who was a good friend of Prince, and mm-hmm. he got the okay from him. So that kind of gave him some validation to go along with the hologram idea. But I don't know. I don't think it was that big of a deal. It was to honor him. So, you know, as long as there was no disrespect in between, I think it was okay.
It was okay. Yeah. So what was your favorite, commercial?
The Alexa commercial.
Really?
Yes. Alexa? I cannot stop watching.
Oh,
all the
love
ads.
It. Oh yeah. My God. I have to it. Say it was mine too. Absolutely. I loved really? It. Loved it.
You know, I just can't get into commercials.
I like
anymore.
Tiffany Haddish's ad commercial too.
Yeah, she did. Yeah.
She's amazing to me. I
she's
love
so
her.
Funny. She's just a funny. Hilarious person. Mm-hmm. I will just say, you know, it was hard for me to kind of really get into the commercials because my favorite all time commercial, and they can never match it, is the E-Trade Babies. Those were my favorite. And when I don't see them anymore, I'm like, oh my gosh, they were like the little babies and they could talk and they would tell you about the E-Trades. And that was my favorite of all time. So when it comes to matching that commercial to everybody, I'm like, they're not the babies. So,
yeah. Speaking of Super Bowl.
Yes.
Can we get into Carson Wentz getting a ring and then gifting a ring to his...
Now
fiance.
Yes. Let's talk about it.
They both have a ring now.
They got a ring. She got it. Amazing. He put a ring on it.
He put a ring on it.
And he got down on the good knee.
Oh!
Yeah.
Philadelphia fans were very worried
because
about
he was
that.
Injured. So, yeah. He got down on one knee and gave her a ring.
That was sweet.
So, that was amazing. And what better time, you know, to give her a ring after mm-hmm. such an mm-hmm. amazing celebration. Mm-hmm. So, I'm all congratulations for them. You know,
I agree. Again, I'm looking amazing. At it was an Instagram post and Twitter post. Mm-hmm. He said he proposed to his girlfriend Madison Oberg. She said yes, and now Maddie and I both got us a ring. Can't wait to marry my best friend. He captioned the photo. God is doing some amazing things, and I can't thank him enough.
Aww.
Awesome, right?
Oh, that's amazing. Love it.
Love it. Now, of course, you know. Bad enough, he lost the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Now, his house was broken into.
Rob Gronkowski. What happened? I mean,
what happened?
That's so upsetting.
It's so.
But
it's
he was really, upsetting. Really cool about it.
He was calm.
Did you hear he called 911. He was like, "Hey, this isn't an emergency, but this is Rob Gronkowski, and my house was robbed when I was gone.
Okay.
At the Super Bowl. As if the police don't know who Rob Gronkowski is.
I know. We all would have been like, I'm sorry.
It sounds a little sketchy, though.
Really?
Because he said he locked the door before he left for the Super Bowl. When he got back, the door was still locked, but another door had been broken down, and whoever robbed his house did not go in his room. So I'm thinking like...
Maybe a maid? Maybe someone that has access to the house?
This was broken inside. A window. His house was broken through a window.
Oh, okay.
But his room remained locked, but his assistant and his roommate had stuff stolen.
Hmm. Oh, okay. Well, that makes it a little more interesting.
Yeah. So they didn't release what happened, like what was stolen.
Mm-hmm. Well,
they
were
saying
guns.
Maybe guns.
Three guns were
but
taken.
But Gronk doesn't have a gun license.
The
roommates do. So
yes.
Makes sense.
I just hope they find him because that's upsetting. No one wants that.
That's upsetting.
gotcha. But, you know, I guess, again, hopefully they'll regain their stuff, you know, and they'll have a happy ever afterlife. But because he was so calm. Maybe he was calm because his stuff didn't get stolen. You think?
Probably.
I mean, I think Gronk made enough money even losing the Super Bowl. I think he can replace
rich.
The three guys better.
Look at Sky. He's over there like, oh, gosh, the
and
Gronk.
And if not, maybe they can call their friend Jimmy G, who cashed out on winning or on them losing the Super Bowl and then got re-signed to a major new contract.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that amazing? Amazing.
Awesome.
So let's talk about traits. What's your thoughts?
Oh, my God.
Trey. That was so crazy this week.
Very, very crazy. So, the Cavaliers just threw everybody away, basically. Isaiah Thomas is gone to the Lakers.
Goodbye.
Again.
Mm-hmm. I know, right? They just keep bouncing him around like a hot potato. Mm-hmm. I hate it.
Mm-hmm. He's just like, gosh. Mm-hmm. He had just been asked, you know, what do you think about being in Cleveland? He's like, I don't want to go anywhere else.
Loved it.
And then the next notification I got, it was like, Isaiah Thomas has been traded. And I was like, what?
Yeah. Like, are you serious?
Mm-hmm. I have loved all the JR memes being like, trying to figure out who's on your team. And he's doing the squinting face.
That's yeah.
My favorite part.
He's like, who are those four guys over there? No,
yeah. So everyone, let's go around and say our names and what position we play.
Right. Where we came
from.
Well,
what's going on?
And then Channing Frye, who is one of my personal favorites. He's really, really funny if you guys follow him on Snapchat. Oh, my God, he's hilarious. He's gone to the Lakers as well.
Mm-hmm.
Iman Shumpert is mm-hmm. going to the Kings.
Mm-hmm.
And they have gained George Hill
mm-hmm.
and Rodney Hood.
Mm-hmm.
Larry Nance Jr.
Mm-hmm.
and Jordan Clarkson.
Wow.
So
that's interesting.
I think it was kind of a bad trade, but it was kind of a good trade.
Yeah.
I'm a little in between. I mean, Jordan Clarkson, Larry Nance Jr., all for it. They're amazing. But losing IT, Iman, Dwayne Wade is
D-Wade,
back at the
D-Wade, right, right.
Can we talk about
Who's
that?
He's not upset about it at
he's
all.
He's not. He's happy.
Did you see Gabrielle dancing the when they got off the plane?
They got off the plane and had a party.
I know. So what was that about? Was he requesting that maybe? I mean, what is that about?
I
mean,
how like he, at this point, he just doesn't
don't care.
It doesn't mm-hmm. matter. He's mm-hmm. just happy to still be playing, you know, whatever.
I gotcha.
But mm-hmm. I don't blame him. I would feel the same way. Derrick Rose and Jay Crowder are going to the Jazz,
mm-hmm.
which I feel like, why? You know, for what?
Right.
But, okay, whatever.
That's the nature of the beast.
It's just what comes with it.
It comes with the territory.
That's what comes with it.
But, you know, I guess the thing, too, let's back up just a little bit. You know, since the Philadelphia Eagles, they did win that big, you know, Super Bowl win. Let's talk about some of the players aren't going to the White House.
Oh, yeah. They're not feeling that. But, I mean, I'm not surprised. I'm honestly not surprised.
Mm-hmm.
It was the same for the Warriors when mm-hmm. they won their mm-hmm. championship. They were like, mm-hmm. we're not going,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Right.
I don't blame them. Chris Long, Torrey Smith.
Yeah.
They have valid reasoning why they don't want to go.
That's true.
And quite frankly, if they don't want to go, they shouldn't have to, even if it is the president, you know. So I don't blame them at all.
Thoughts, Alicia?
I just respect Chris Long saying, you know, mm-hmm. I don't want to look back and have to tell my son that I did something that I didn't believe in.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
And so as a dad, I'm not a dad, but him as
of
a
course.
Dad, mm-hmm. I respect that because he's doing what he believes in and he's obviously someone who is not playing football for money. You know, he gave away his whole paycheck all year.
Amazing.
And I just think that he's like a stand-up guy and he's a man of his word. And
mm-hmm.
if he's not all in for something, then he's not going to go.
I mean, that's fair, though. You know, because if you think about it, this has been, you know, such a weird year altogether. But just to hear, you know, the president curse them out.
Yeah.
You know, on national TV.
He said some really degrading things.
Really
about
degrading
them.
Things.
So I respect it.
If they're not going to go, you know. I understand on both sides, but I also understand that. I don't know. I was always raised, you know, being a Southerner, you know, in order to gain respect, you have to, you know.
You have to earn it.
Respect is earned. And a thing about it, when you're degrading people, I don't know, many people would like to be in the comfort of anyone that's, they know that.
Well, I think, yeah, Torrey Smith said the same thing. And he's like, you know I'm not going to go to a party if I feel like that person has said mean things or don't respect women or, you know, have, you know, like said bad things about minorities. So it's no different. It's not just because it's the president or it's mm-hmm. the White House. Like, mm-hmm. I would do that in my regular life.
Interesting. Well, again, I commend them for standing up for what they believe in. You
me
know,
too.
Again, the saying goes, stand for something or fall for anything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, moving right along to Mr. Dirk.
Oh,
Dirk.
Hey, Dirk.
Dirk Nowitzki. Okay. Alicia, tell us what Dirk did this week.
50,000 minute club.
Shut the front door.
Player.
Wow. Okay.
Yes. He stayed healthy, played awesome. A long time. Loved he just it. Joined Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Kevin yes. Garnett, mm-hmm. Jason Kidd, mm-hmm. played in the jersey mm-hmm. with his name spelled wrong.
Incorrect.
Poor guy.
But, I mean, could you even get any worse?
You know those things, it's like, equipment manager, you have one job.
Yeah.
One job. You
that's
know
it.
You know it's coming. You know this is going to be a big game for yeah. him.
Like, all this time, nobody.
Nobody.
Called. I mean, nobody.
You know, he didn't even know it. Whenever he was oh, no. out, he was like, to be honest, like, I.
He didn't even notice it. Oh, my gosh.
Wow. But I guess that's indicative of our season.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Did yeah. he say that?
Well, yes.
Okay.
There, I concur.
I concur. But if you think about it, Erica, me, because Alicia, your name is so simple. My name, everyone wants to put an A at the end of my name. No matter who I meet, it's always Yakira. And I'm like, no, it's just Yakiri. So knowing Erica, too, your name is yeah. spelt a little different.
Mine has two R's, but yeah. everybody wants it to be like.
One R.
I've heard so many ridiculous things, like a Q. Like, do you have a Q in your name? No. It's just an extra R.
Yeah,
it's not that serious.
It's just R. So we can relate to those yeah. name misspellings. And when I see it, it's not a big deal. So I can relate to him.
Mm-hmm. You know, well, I think for him, it's like, you know what? I don't really care if you spell my name right because you'll remember me for
you know who I am.
As long as you get my last name right on my paycheck.
That's it, right?
I don't care.
Oh,
you know
yes.
who I am.
Love that, Alicia.
You know who I am. And in the words of Marshawn Lynch, you know why I'm here.
All day.
You know why I'm here.
You know why I'm here.
That's all that matters.
So.
You know, but again, congratulations to Dirk. He's out there doing some fabulous things.
Dirk's great.
You know, I'm not quite understanding this situation here with Magic Johnson's anti-tampering.
Oh, God.
I mean, because it seems as if, I mean, it wasn't like he said anything negative.
He didn't.
He got asked in an interview
yeah.
what he thought about the kid, who I'm going to butcher his name.
So that's okay. Take your time.
I'm not going to even say it.
Giannis.
Yes.
Keep it at Giannis.
So.
Just keep it simple.
So he basically said he was being compared to Magic. So whenever he was interviewed by an ESPN writer, he mm-hmm. just said, you know, the kid's awesome. He's going to win championships mm-hmm. for Milwaukee.
That's what he said.
That's all he said. And it was simply a compliment. Tampering? That's reaching. I mean, that's reaching.
I just think it's ridiculous.
That's reaching.
They fined them, what,
$50,000 for a compliment?
Yeah.
Gotta be kidding.
It was a compliment, you
gotta
know.
Gotta be kidding.
And again, it says it goes against, what is the league policy or something of that
everything
nature.
Everything is tampering.
You know? Tampering yeah. and it's just weird. And I was
but
just,
this isn't the first time they've been fined for this.
Hmm.
They got fined back in August. Mm-hmm. General manager Rob Pelinka made contact with Paul George's agent,
okay.
which constituted a prohibited expression of interest in the player while he was under contract.
Hmm.
So that is the violation.
And the violation here.
But
tampering.
I just think that's ridiculous.
Guys' eyes are stuck in the back of his head.
Like what?
And how are you going to get a new contract if you don't talk to the agent?
I know.
That's just stupid.
That's stupid.
But again,
in the words of Prince, it's a sign of the times.
It's a sign of the times.
Sign of the times.
Love it.
It's crazy. We have an amazing guest coming up shortly. And before we do, let's head on to our SMH OMG moment. Yes. Alicia, yes.
SMH OMG moments up next.
Hashtag Chicks in the Sports tags your best.
Yay!
Yes! SMH right. OMG.
Yes. This SMH OMG moment comes on the only day that mm-hmm. everybody gets excited about 18-year-olds sending them a fax. I am talking about National Signing Day.
Love
oh,
it.
Yeah. Yes. So let's go down to Florida.
Okay.
All right.
Biggest Let's day see. Of this kid's life. We're going to talk about it. Jacob Copeland, ranked number 5 wide receiver in the nation.
Wow.
And so he's making the decision. Where is he going to go play football? He's got Tennessee,
mm-hmm.
he's got Alabama, and then he's got the University of Florida.
Yeah.
All lined up. National television picks the Florida Gators, and Mama, wearing an Alabama shirt and a Tennessee
Mama.
Hat,
yes.
gets up and walks
what?
Out.
Yes, she
Mama
did.
Mama gathered her things and said, I'm out.
Deuces.
In front of the camera.
In front of
right.
the camera.
She was not poised at all. It wasn't like
she
even had
was
the... She didn't even do the church, excuse me, with your hand
right.
up.
Right. Not even
excuse
a cute
me.
One.
Right. She got, look, her purse.
Well, I'm
missing
out.
Purse.
Forget it.
Do you see this
you
purse?
Know?
She's got her purse.
But But the OMG to all of this is that this is not the first time that a mom has been upset about where their kids have gone to school.
Really?
So Two years ago, Landon Collins chose Bama over his mom's favorite school, LSU. And then flash forward, his little brother, 2 years later, Jared Willis picks Florida, and Mama is still upset.
Oh, Mama. Mama,
let it go. But, you know, I guess the thing, the beauty about being a mom is allowing your kids to make their own decisions. You know, whether you like those decisions or not, they're making very respectable decisions because these are opportunities that could lead to so much more
in their adult life.
Yes. So, as a mom, I don't get it. Again, everyone is not like me, but again, I'm just like, I just didn't understand her.
Why just think you have to support it?
The thing that I saw, I was looking into it, and what I saw is her reasoning for walking out was he was affiliated with, like, gangs and stuff
at one point
in Florida, so she kind of wanted him to get away, new scenery, and, you know, she didn't want him to get caught up with those same temptations because he's in such a good position right now. But at the same time, you know, he's making an adult decision for his life. This is going to benefit him. Mm-hmm. And so if this is what he feels is in his best interest, you should support him no matter what. You know?
Well, not even that, but it's like you're going to play D1 football. You're not going to have time. You're not going to have time to get in trouble because you have coaches and the whole staff
that will be on you.
Watching you.
Yeah.
Any mom should be happy that your kid
is going to school.
Going to school for free.
Yes. Keyword, freebies.
$0.
Right.
He's going to do what he loves to do. I mean, you have to be happy for, you know.
You do.
But I'm glad that she actually came back and gave him a hug and supported him. So, you know, but I wonder what the conversation was like when they got back home, you know. Like, Mom, what?
I know, right?
That car ride home was not fun.
It was a long ride.
Jacob's not happy about
it. She did some cursing. She did some cursing.
Yep.
Now, that was Alicia's SMH OMG moment for the week. Let's go. Okay, we're back. We have something to talk about, right?
We do.
This is a crazy week. Okay, as you guys see, we... Sky. We have...
Hey, yo, what's good? This is the mayor right here. East Coast repping to the fullest. And I'm in the Chicks in the Sports. And right about now, you're locked in the Chicks in the Sports. Go ahead and do what you do, ladies. Rock out.
Hey, my name is Ulrich Johnson, former NFL player, singer, actor, and you're listening to Chicks into Sports.
Now, okay, I'm back. Me and Erica and Alicia.
Hello.
Oh, my gosh. Crazy, crazy week. But, okay, so me and Erica, we went to a special event this week. It was so fun.
It was amazing.
Next time, Alicia, you got to be with us.
I got to be there.
It was amazing. Great. You should have been there. It was awesome.
They gave us shirts. See the shirts? Atlanta Dream.
We're sporting our shirts, and they ran out of our sizes. So,
yes,
we look huge, but that's okay. That's
Atlanta Dream, Atlanta Dream. We love those guys.
We're big supporting.
Icebox, Atlanta Dream.
Yeah.
Craziness. We sat down with the coach. We had to talk to several of you, the president. It was an amazing time.
We talked to a couple of the athletic trainers.
Emory University.
Emory.
Yeah.
We also talked to head coach Nikki Collin,
who's
new. She's awesome.
Love her.
She's so amazing. She has a wonderful vision for the Atlanta Dream. And I really hope that everything she wants comes to fruition. She moved from Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a big culture change. And I asked her, you know, I was like, how was that change going from Connecticut to Atlanta, which is like a super hot spot? You know, she has 3 children.
Yeah.
So, you know, she's like, you know, it was really exciting.
Mm-hmm.
But as she was like recruiting, she's like, you know, it's so easy to sell these girls to Atlanta because, you know, I mean, it's such a great place to be. So she's like, you know, I'm grateful to be here and so excited for what's coming up. So I'm really, really happy she's here. And I really am hoping for an awesome season.
I am too. And what's so crazy about everything, I just know that this year is going to be a little bit different because I believe, you know, Coach Nikki is doing a phenomenal. She has a wonderful vision for the team. Mm-hmm. I think the setup now, their players can more so relate more. It's kind of what she kind of interpreted to, you know, because it's just, it comes natural. I mean, you can relate to women and their and all of our issues because we have
the
those
job. And if have you're a woman, you time. Get it. If yeah. you're a woman, you understand. There's emotions.
There's emotions.
There's PMS.
There's bad days.
There's gonna be bad days. There's gonna be drama sometimes. So you know, and you want to avoid it at all costs, of course. But being a woman, you understand what comes with this job, dealing with just. Well, not just women, because there's men on the staff, but as
but
a
you
team,
understand.
As a team coaching a team of all women, you have to understand what comes with that. So I'm glad that, you know, she's here and she's able to connect with the players and love how they play and really know them for who they are.
Absolutely.
And not just, you know, I'm your coach, whatever, there's nothing out of it. To really strive to create a personal relationship with these girls.
But you know what's interesting about that, too? I had a time, you know, to sit down with the Atlanta Dream fans over the summertime. And this was when they were searching for a coach. And most of the fans, believe it or not, were like, we want a woman coach. And I was like, really? Why? Are you being a cliche? You know, what is that about? But they were just saying to, like, it seems like a woman would be able to relate more to the team.
Yeah.
You know, and we definitely want somebody. You know, these were hardcore Atlanta Dream fans. They were like, we want to win. And I was like, of course you do. But again, the majority of them were really unanimously wanting a woman coach. So I think this is a great move for the Atlanta Dream.
Yeah, awesome.
I'm definitely looking forward to the future and to some wonderful giveaways. Atlanta Dream. Giveaways coming
Atlanta
soon.
Dream. Free stuff.
Yes, freebies. Who doesn't love freebies? Raise your hand. But, you know, also talking about freebies, I forgot to tell you guys, we will be have some Universal Soul tickets.
Oh.
Yeah, they're coming up. Yes, yes. So we're going to put that out there.
Yeah.
We're going to start promoting those.
Yeah.
So listeners, be prepared for that. But again, you know, Atlanta Dream, we're rocking with Atlanta Dream. And we also, it's time to get to our interview.
Yeah.
What is her name?
Imani McGee Stafford.
Yes. Let's go.
Game on, game on. This is your girl, the self-proclaimed sportsnista, Yakiri Thomas. And I have a very exciting guest today with us. Erica, aren't you excited?
So excited.
Oh, my gosh. So this beautiful young lady stands at an impressive 6'7" feet tall of lovingness, and she's a former basketball player for the University of Texas at Austin, who left her name in record books, becoming the first UT women's basketball player to garner over 1,000 points, rebounds, 1,000 rebounds, and 200, Erica, 200 blocks.
Wow.
200? 200.
Wow.
She is now a basketball center for the Atlanta Dream. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Imani McGee Stafford.
Yes.
Hello, Imani.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. I cannot complain.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. So I'm so excited to talk to you this morning. It has been such a wonderful, wonderful day. And Erica and I have been sitting here just enamored by everything that you've
just
done.
Just gushing.
You know? Just gushing, you know? And could you just...
Oh, you guys flatter me.
We definitely, you know, we kind of went over your story. Such an amazing story. Such an inspiration. Your story is definitely about survival, you know? And we definitely want you to kind of tell the listeners about your story.
Yeah, tell us about your poetry also.
Yes.
Yeah, that's really awesome. Can you tell us about it?
Yes, ma'am. So I grew up in an abusive home. I hate saying abusive home because it makes people think that your parents are terrible people, and my parents are great. It just kind of was just luck of the draw. Like, they weren't prepared to have a child. Things happened, and I just kind of, unfortunately, I was abused by my family member growing up. And so I was very severely depressed growing up, and I kind of say, like, poetry and basketball saved my life. Like,
wow,
that's awesome.
I grew up in a basketball family. My mom's a Hall of Famer. My dad played. His sister played in the WNBA. My mom played in the WNBA.
Of course
she
did.
My older brother plays in the NBA now.
Right.
So obviously, like, I was supposed to play basketball, but when I was younger, I just played because it got me attention. Like, my dad came to all the games. Like, my mom came to the game. So,
that's amazing. That's amazing. But, you know, I guess the question for me, you know, having such a dynamic family, of course, you mentioned your mom was a former WNBA player. Your dad has also played overseas.
And your brother
I'm sorry,
plays
yes,
for the Warriors.
Your brother? I'm sorry, what is his name? What is his name again? Who? Is it
My brother?
Yeah, what is his name?
JaVale McGee.
JaVale McGee. Just that little guy that plays over there at the Warriors.
He just plays for the Warriors.
Nobody we know right now. But that's amazing, you know, just to have that family dynamic, that dynasty. Was there pressure to be a basketball player?
So I grew up with my dad. Mm-hmm. So his whole argument was like I started playing basketball really late. I didn't really start playing basketball seriously until like high school.
Okay.
I played a little bit growing up, but mm-hmm. as soon as I got in trouble and I talked a lot, I was always in trouble. My dad would take away basketball.
Mm-hmm.
And then I tried to play seriously in seventh grade. In my first game, I broke my ankle.
Oh, man.
That was pretty much my career before high school. My dad was just kind of like, you're going to play basketball, whether you know it or not. And at the time, I did not know it. I was into computers, acting, anything but sports.
Mm-hmm.
And I was also like 6'5 or 13. So he was like, you're going to play basketball eventually.
Six, five.
I don't want to make you. I don't want to force you to play a sport. So.
Right. But, you know, I guess we're in a saga, or we're in the era right now of the hashtag Me Too. And just knowing about your courage and how you were able to come out and tell your story, we definitely commend you on that.
Absolutely. The way that you're able to use poetry to really convey your story to others is amazing. And mm-hmm. some people use short stories, some people use novels, but poetry is very powerful. I'm an English minor, so I totally get it. I'm taking a poetry class right now. So poetry is really amazing. So the way that you're able to convey your story and to inspire others and to let them know that, you know, they're not alone is really amazing. So we definitely commend you for that.
Absolutely. Yeah. And, you know, I guess overall, we definitely want to just, again, you know, the hashtag Me Too is such a big thing right now.
Mm-hmm.
For any of the listeners that are going through situations where they have been molested, you know, and I know that depression goes along with that in situations where you are having, you know, things to happen to you as a woman. Is there anything you would tell the listeners right now from your experience? What should they do if they find themselves in that situation?
The Me Too hashtag is amazing. And I love to have a conversation like, wow, centered around women. There are a lot of men that are speaking up as well.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
Like Terry Crews, I think he's a national hero right now.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah,
just because, like, he's a very large man and he was willing to acknowledge that, yes, I was sexually assaulted as well. And I think the problem with our society in general is that we paint victims and mm-hmm. people dealing with mental health as mm-hmm. a very specific picture, right? Somebody mm-hmm. really weak and vulnerable mm-hmm. and fragile. And that's one of the biggest reasons I speak out now. Because I don't look like a victim.
Right.
I don't look like what a victim's supposed to look like. I'm very tall. I have a very big personality. I'm a very strong personality. But I was abused growing up. I was sexually abused growing up. You know what I mean? So I think the more we have these conversations, the real conversations, and acknowledge that there is no stereotypical victim, no stereotypical assailant, that 75% of victims do know their abuser, and we have that conversation, is where it helps alleviate these problems and make victims understand that they're not alone. I don't really like the word victim, but it helps people understand that they're not alone, and unfortunately this is a very normal problem we have in our society right now. And until we start having actual conversations and changing the way we talk about sexual abuse and sexual violence and having a real conversation about it, it's not going to end. And I like to say, like, I imagine a world where these heinous individuals that commit these acts of sexual violence, commit these sexual crimes,
mm-hmm.
were so scared to do it because of how they would be received or how their friends would think of them, as opposed to how scared women and men are to come forward about being abused because of how they'll be seen or if they'll be believed or how their friends will interact with them after that.
Absolutely.
Imagine if the tables were turned.
Right. Yeah. That is an aha moment. So again, you know, tell the listeners, what is your aha moment? What is your expectations and what do you foresee us doing for the Atlanta Dream? We have a wonderful team that's
We're so excited to have you.
Right. So excited. Coach Nikki, you know, amazing. Angel is back. You know, so many things that are happening with the Atlanta Dream.
So many big announcements.
So many big, ginormous announcements. Are you seeing a championship coming our way?
Can we have a dunk? What's going on? What's going on? We need action.
Right?
I'm excited for this season. I've spoken to Coach Nikki. I'm excited for her vision for the team, her vision for me. So I'm just trying to come in and work hard and hopefully definitely to make the playoffs. That's obviously, that needs to be a goal every year.
And absolutely.
Last year we didn't make the playoffs, so that's something we have an immediate goal, something to change. But having Angel back, obviously, she's one of the best players in the league, so having her back is going to be a great help. And we got a young core, and so it's going to be really excited. It's going to be a really good season, and we're going to be working hard, and hopefully we can make a deep playoff run.
Love it. This is awesome. Now, Erica, you have any more questions for her?
So I have one question. So having a new head coach, mm-hmm. Nikki Collin, who's amazing. We just recently got to meet her this week. Mm-hmm. So how was your interaction with meeting her? I mean, what are your thoughts on having her as a new head coach?
So we spoke on the phone for the first time. We had been mm-hmm. texting back and forth. Okay. But I hadn't been able to meet her in person just because I've been traveling and she's been traveling. Mm-hmm. But we had a very long conversation the other day. It was great. She's great. I haven't heard any bad reviews from her from the multiple people that I know that have interacted with her. And she's young, she's mm-hmm. exciting, and she's really excited for what we can do with this team. And I think with basketball, it's not so much about how talented you are anymore, especially at this level. Mm-hmm. It's about how well you can use pieces and how you fit into whatever equation your coach is making. So
I get it.
It's exciting to be joining a team and being in a team setting where the coach knows how I play, enjoys how I play, and sees me having a role on her team. So
love it. That's awesome. That's an awesome coach athlete relationship to have.
I love it. I love it. I love it. Now, it comes a time now where we have to do the five for five.
Five for five.
Yes. Now, are you ready, Imani? These are going to be just silly questions. We get your mind rolling, get you super uber excited about Chits in the Sports. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Question number one. Why is a basketball orange and black?
That's a really good question.
I was thinking the same thing.
I'm going to say for visibility purposes.
I love it. I love it. Who would win a fight? Superwoman or Catwoman?
Definitely Superwoman.
Okay.
Thank you. Yeah.
All right. Okay. So if you could have one thing during a zombie apocalypse, what would that one thing be?
Oh, I just watched a zombie movie with my dad.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm
going
to go with, like one of those, like, face masks or something.
Oh, okay.
So,
That's
great. I can breathe.
Body armor.
Yes.
Exactly. Love it. Now, okay, this is a serious question for you. If there was a dance-off, the Atlanta Dream dance-off, and you were one of the people that were chosen, who would you choose to dance against?
Ooh.
Yes.
To dance against.
Yes. Who would it be?
I'd probably say Elizabeth because I think I can beat her.
And that's amazing because Elizabeth will be on in a couple of weeks. So uh-huh. We will definitely tell her about
We're going to have to tell Elizabeth about your calling her out.
I know, right? We definitely have to do that. Now, when it's all said and done, what would you say your legacy will be?
I hope my legacy. I created an environment where people feel safe, mm-hmm. safe enough to not only live in their truth, but speak their truth. Mm-hmm. My goal is always to be bigger than myself. You know what I mean? Like, I think my purpose is to use this platform that basketball gives me to speak about taboo issues such as mental health and sexual abuse, and hopefully change the dynamic and really start making headway in changing this epidemic that we have as a country.
I love it. Amazing, awesome. Amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, such an amazing, beautiful guest, Imani McGee Stafford. Thank you so much, Imani. And you definitely have to come back and come inside the studio with us, girls. We're representing. We got on our Atlanta Dream shirts. We ready for you, girl.
Thank you guys for having me.
Thank you. You have a wonderful day. Thank you so much, Imani.
Hey, this is Sports Diva Erica Blunt. You are now tuning into Chicks into Sports. I'm that chick that's gonna tell it like a T.I. is.
Birthdays! A dog athlete who became one of the oldest rookies in the NFL and inspired the 2006 Disney movie Invincible. He recovered two fumbles and caught a 15-yard pass during his 3 years in the NFL with the Philadelphia Eagles. Vince Papale turned 72. cornerback who won Super Bowl 49 and 51 as a member of the New England Patriots. He was selected by the Patriots in the third round of the 2013 NFL Draft. Logan Ryan turns 27. NBA point guard who became a longtime starter for the Orlando Magic after joining the team in 2004. He helped lead the Magic to the NBA Finals in 2009 when they were defeated by no one other than the Los Angeles Lakers. Jameer Nelson turns 36. Small forward who was named first team All-ACC and ACC Defensive Player of the Year in his final year with the Clemson Tigers. He was drafted in the second round of the 2014 NBA Draft by the Philadelphia 76ers, then traded to the Houston Rockets midway through his first season. KJ McDaniels turns 25. Former center fielder for the New York Mets, who was best known for hitting the ground ball that helped the Mets win the 1986 World Series, Mookie Wilson turns 62. Former free-swinging MLB first baseman and outfielder and baseball analyst who played in Major League Baseball for the San Diego Padres, Philadelphia Phillies, and Chicago White Sox from 1986 to 1995. John Cook turns 57. Venezuelan Major League catcher who made his first All-Star game in 2008. He played in the Major League Baseball for the New York Yankees, Los Angeles Dodgers, Tampa Bay Rays. Dionir Navarro turns 34. Right-handed pitcher for the Arizona Diamondbacks since 2013, who had begun his professional career in the Atlanta Braves organization in 2011 and 2012. Randall Delgado turns 28. Happy birthday! This day in sports lovelies, the year was 1992. Magic Johnson returned for his All-Star Game appearance after he stunned the world 3 months earlier with the news he had contracted HIV. And of course, he immediately retired. But again, the year was 1992. On this day in sports, Magic Johnson returns to play in the 42nd NBA All-Star Game that happened in Orlando, Florida, where he was greeted by the crowd with a standing ovation. Picture it, people. This day in sports, 1992.
Hey, it's Alita Lee, and you are now tuning in to Chicks Into Sports. I'm that chick who's going to state facts and give you the tea.
Guess what time it is? You already know what time it is. It is WNBA news, y'all. You already know, sports lovelies, this is my favorite time of the show. Not only did we have a spectacular week this week, hanging out with the Atlanta Dream and having an awesome guest come on and chat. WNBA Atlanta Dream. Of course, this is the time I get to talk Atlanta Dream WNBA news, y'all. Now, of course, this has been such a busy week for the Atlanta Dream. The Atlanta Dream has announced its 2018 schedule, sports lovelies, y'all. The Atlanta Dream will tip off its first season under head coach Nikki Collin on the road against the Dallas Wings on Sunday, May 20th, as part of the hashtag WNBA All Day and WNBA Tip Off powered by Verizon. According to the 2018 WNBA schedule, which was released on Thursday by league officials. Now, Coach Collin and the Dream will make their first appearance at home on Saturday. Make sure you're there Saturday, May 26th. Beginning at 6 p.m. against the Wings at the McCamish Pavilion on the Georgia Tech campus. The Atlanta Dream signed forward Jessica Breland. Yes, now Atlanta Dream head coach Nikki Collin announced the signing of unrestricted free agent Jessica Breland to a multi-year contract. Jessica is a huge get for us, Collin said. It was a hard decision for her to leave a place that was comfortable for her and take a chance on the Dream and me. But I am incredibly thankful for the chance to coach her. I believe she's a perfect fit for our tempo system. I can't wait to see her in a Dream uniform. Now, of course, Atlanta Dream also signed Maggie Lucas to a training camp contract. Now, the Atlanta Dream signed guard Maggie Lucas to a training camp contract announced on Tuesday. Now, Maggie has had a string of bad luck with ACLs. I can say with certainty
No one attacks rehab harder than she does, Colin said. My hope for Maggie is that she enters training camp ready to compete at her pre-injury level. Now, of course, Emory Healthcare has been named the official team and healthcare and sports medicine provider for the Atlanta Dream. Yes. Now, of course, this was announced as well with a shared commitment to improve maintenance of athletes' health. Emory Healthcare and the Atlanta Dream have announced an expansion of their current partnership with a designation of Emory as the official team healthcare and official sports medicine provider. Congratulations again. So much awesomeness is happening in the city of Atlanta for our favorite Atlanta Dream team. And last but not least, WNBA All-Star and two-time Olympic gold medalist Angel McCautry has signed a multi-year contract with the Atlanta Dream and has announced her intentions to return to the Atlanta franchise for the 2018 season. Yes! Now here's a soundbite of what she had to say from Twitter.
Dream fans, what's up? It's me, Angel McCautry. Guess what? I have a great announcement to make. I'm returning to the Atlanta Dream. Thank you guys for all your support and my rest last summer. I can't wait to see you guys. New start, new coach, so it's going to be amazing. See you soon.
Yes! Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for the 2018 season. So many wonderful things that are happening, and I cannot wait to share for the upcoming weeks to come. So excited, y'all. I'm so excited. And you already know, if I can run with the Atlanta Dream, you should be running with the Atlanta Dream. Let's all run with the Atlanta Dream 2018. Yes! It's one dream. Let's go, Atlanta Dream 2018. Let's go!
I'm Ashley Barnett, and you're listening to Chicks Into Sports. I'm the one that's going to tell it like it is. I don't get it, do you? Type of money, everybody acting like they know you. Let me
hear you say, ladies all across the world, listen up, we're looking for a group. So much to talk about. During the little break, we have been debating a few things, and we need y'all's help. Erica, give us the rundown on what is going on.
What is that? I'm so confused.
Oh, my God. So Jason Tatum has got too much going on right now. Apparently, so he's just welcomed a new baby. Congratulations.
Yes, he did. Congratulations.
With his longtime high school sweetheart, mm-hmm. who we're trying to figure out if they are together because he's supposed to be dating Sammy Amos, a really famous volleyball player. Oh. So we're trying to figure out, are you still with baby
the
mom?
Team?
Are you with Sammy? What's the tea? I mean, what's going on? I mean, and is there drama because maybe Sammy thinks you're still dating her, but you're saying that you're not. So, I want to know what's going on.
That's interesting.
I want to know what's happening.
What is happening here?
I mean, the whole two girlfriends thing is interesting. I don't think that was really his aim, but I just feel like maybe there needs to be some clarification.
Clarification
for all parties involved.
Oh my gosh. I mean, that's an interesting story because I mean, you're saying that there's the baby mama. Was she the side chick?
No. They were together since like high school. She moved to Boston and everything, and they just had a baby. But he's dating
someone else,
somebody else now. They've been dating for
so she's the side chick.
So she's kind of the side chick.
We just want to know who's the main chick.
Who's the main chick?
Who's the side?
But I just think that we can all go on record and say having two girlfriends is probably not the best idea.
Not at all.
Because
there's the Lou Williams.
Oh my gosh. But what happened? Didn't someone else have a baby too?
Well, Lou Williams, like he said he had a tweet or a statement of something. And he was talking about, you know, having two girlfriends. Mm-hmm. And he was saying, you know, he has two girlfriends and they know about each other and they're okay with it. But Shannon Sharp, like, tweeted and was like, why are you dry snitching? Like, he was saying, like, you know, everybody in the league does it. And Shannon Sharp was like, whoa,
Did he say that?
He was like, wait a minute. Okay. He was like, a lot of people do it in the league more than you know. And so Shannon Sharp was like, can you not, like, put us on front street? Don't dry snitch. Like, what are you doing? So they were kind of going at it for a little bit on Twitter about that. So he's not really talking about cheating, but I don't know. I think Shannon Sharp just probably exposed himself and didn't mean to.
I
think he should have just kept it quiet.
Yes, all day. I mean, sometimes it's best to just keep everything
on a hush. Keep it on
a hush. Oh, gosh. Guy already got to say something.
Oh, no, I was just going to say, you're not going to keep Shannon Sharpe quiet about anything.
Yes, yeah.
I mean, he was one of them that brought up and tweeted the fact that Tom Brady didn't shake Foles' hands after the game. He brought, he's like, put that out there, put it out there.
Just so you know.
Just so you know.
Just because Shannon knows it all.
And he does, and he does.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's interesting. I just think, too, they are young dads. These are some young people.
They're young, and they're probably just experiencing life, doing different stuff. Who knows? Who knows?
Different stuff. Is that what we call that now?
Jason, I hope I hope everything's all right at home.
I hope so, too. I hope so,
everything
too.
Is all right. And he's only 19.
19 years
That's
old.
There's a whole lot of life happening to you at 19. You know?
It changes a lot. I think eventually, you know, the maturity, if it's not already there, well, obviously, he has to get some maturity, but kids change a lot.
Mm-hmm. Kids change your life.
Yes, so, forever.
And then being in the NBA that young, I mean, that changes your life completely. You have to move, you know, with your kid. You have to make arrangements for, you know, how you're going to see your kid or where you're going to be. You know, they travel a lot. So that's just, he's got a whole lot of life-changing moments going on. So I hope he's maintaining and doing all right.
Oh, I think you all. You know, and I just got a breaking news. Well, that was yesterday. One of the fans were stabbed.
Oh, my God.
Fan stabbed officers assaulted during the Eagles Super Bowl victory party. Oh, Bleacher's Report has reported it. Just going awry over there.
They are throwing a riot. I don't know what's going on.
What is that? You know,
they're predicting like 4 or 5 people will die during this celebration.
What is going on?
Really?
Is that serious?
I guess. I don't know. I don't know. I think... I'm from them burning stuff up and flipping cars. I'm so confused. Like, why?
It's the Philly way.
It's the Philly way.
The Philly way, I guess.
If the Falcons won, would we have reacted like that? Is that Southerners?
Absolutely.
We would have not. Yes. We have poise.
The video from Brian was incredible. I loved it. There, you couldn't see the street. You couldn't see anything. It was only just that weird blue color. Everywhere you could see. Everywhere. And I had Chris Long in a fur jacket. You had Jason Kelce in some sort of like, I'm going to show you all the picture. Okay. I don't even know what kind of costume this was. And he had a really, really touching little doubter speech. But like, this is what homeboy is wearing.
Oh my gosh.
He looks like a leprechaun.
I'm not even sure what it is. He kind of looks like a genie, maybe.
Oh, my gosh.
Y'all, we are going to tweet out a picture of this. I don't know what's going on, but they were celebrating big. The players were celebrating even bigger. Mm-hmm. And please stop stabbing people.
I know.
Keep celebrating. Let's not die over it.
Yeah. Let's all just live and be merry, okay?
In this moment.
In the city of brotherly love.
In brotherly love, right?
Right.
Insane. But, you know, again, congratulations to everyone out there that won. And play it safe. Be safe in the streets of brotherly love, Philly. Brotherly love. You know, I definitely want to touch on one more topic. There's so much that's going on this week. But what's your thoughts on this Floyd Mayweather thing? Do you think that he is actually going to go through with the fight? I know we spoke about that briefly last week. We talked about, you know, Conor McGregor is trying to...
If the money is right, you think Floyd will do it.
Money Mayweather is going to do anything for money.
He will. If the money is right, he will do it.
He's a guy...
Not lose. He don't want to lose. He goes into that ring, he's going to lose.
That's the conflicting thing. He's going to get
But he's not
going to
do it.
If he does it.
Because you have to think about it. Floyd picks who he wants to fight. Mm-hmm. Floyd knows who he can beat. He's not going to pick somebody. Right. He's not going to. And that UFC fighting, that's so much different. You don't get. Right. You can't determine who's going to hit you in the face with their feet.
Right.
Okay? I'm just
be
saying.
You'll be bleeding out by the time
no
it's
bloody,
over.
Teeth missing. You know, that is not going to happen.
That's just so not Floyd. So I don't.
I think they're just
hyping
it up.
If the money is right, he might do it. But at the same time, I know he doesn't want to risk his record.
Keep himself relevant.
Yeah, I think so, too. Yeah. I think this is just out there.
It's just a beef.
Yeah, that's all. Well, ladies, we've come to the time. It's almost time for us to say goodbye. You know, I was very excited about our guest, Imani, today. She was a wonderful guest.
Yes, Imani was amazing.
You know, she was so amazing. She was brutally honest about her story, you know, just a survivor of child molestation and to go on to be this mega superstar and to continue to support others, especially finding other outlets to support your emotions during that time.
Absolutely. She was really, really inspirational, and she said some really encouraging things, you know, to people who might be going through the same thing or, you know, have experienced the same thing and can relate. So I really do admire her courage and her poetry and how she found an outlet for herself to really express herself. You know, a lot of times when you go through that kind of thing, you don't really know how to express how you feel. You don't think anybody will understand, but, you know, finding an outlet like writing or reading, whatever, is really, really genius. So I loved it.
Love it.
She's amazing, and I hope to see great things from her. Imani, give us a dunk now.
Back in the studio.
We want to see it. We want some action this season.
Well, so what's happening this week? Are we doing anything special? I'm sure something will pop up that we'll have to attend. Which isn't a bad thing. I'm happy about it, you know? You ready, Alicia?
I'm ready.
Ready to take on the city of the A?
Let's go.
Let's do
it. What's your Georgia hat on? UGA?
Huh? Oh, let's not push it.
Okay, I'm just saying. I was just wondering. I was just... No?
No.
Not even if I brought, like, a hoodie?
But you said there's no beef. We will have bets one day.
Okay.
And then we'll make that happen. But until then, I'm just going to say congratulations to Georgia, who had the top signing class. And good luck next
time. Come on. You know you want to shout out Clemson. Go ahead and brag about Clemson getting six, state number one. Jordan, you can do it.
Coming in with six number one top picks from every different state.
Whatever.
Six.
Okay.
Number one player in six different states.
That's great.
Go Tigers.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, yeah, go Tigers.
Right out of Alabama's feet.
Yes. Oh. Nothing else to say about that.
Yeah.
Now it comes to my motivational moment. Have to get in that moment of motivation. Sports lovelies, week after week, I say the same thing every week. It never changes. And the saying goes, because it's so true, it doesn't matter how slow you go, so as long as you do not stop, you will eventually finish. Remember, dreams don't come true until you what? You wake up and you go to work. Now be sure to check us out on Facebook. Like us. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram. Check us out the same place, same time, Atlanta's Real 1100. Radio station. Now, ladies, the game will never be the same.
Game on! Yeah!